Welcome back to another Reaction Monday. And obviously, I am not sounding too good. And the reason I'm not sounding too good and the reason I'm wearing a mask is I'm hoping that the droplets that come out of my mouth don't go through this little microphone and then into your room. Because I'm about 95% sure I knew it was going to come at some point, and long story short, last week obviously was after Christmas and New Year's. We went back to school, and on Tuesday we had a student come into our room that was kind of coughing and sneezing, and I had my mask on. I didn't have my mask on at the very beginning because no one was in the room, and I just hate wearing a mask all day long. Which, by the way, this is K95. This is from Korea. These are like the actual high grade mask, not the stupid covering that really doesn't do anything. By the way, those coverings don't do anything for you. It's the actual mask. I mean, they use these before because Korea has some bad air, and this actually helps with the bad air. But I can't stand wearing them all day, so I had it off. She came in the room, and I didn't like put it on right away until I heard her coughing. And when I heard her coughing, I was like, oh, and so I put it back on. Now, again, I can't prove that this is from her, but after about 20 minutes of her being in there, she started eating some oranges and she said, I can't taste these. So I was like, oh, no, shit. So we sent her home, and then on Friday morning, I woke up and I had something in my throat, kind of like a frog in my throat. And I thought, I hope that's just a cold maybe. But I thought it also was because the 2 days before that, I had taught a lot in class. And I thought maybe I overextended my voice because I was talking a lot and we hadn't been in school for 2 weeks. And so maybe that was the problem. But Friday night I got home and my body started aching and I got a fever and I was like, yeah, I'm pretty sure I got it. All day yesterday I was in bed pretty much with a high fever, not a high fever, about 99.2, 99.4. And it would kind of come and go. At night I felt a little bit better after dinner. Then it came back, and then today I've kind of been feeling the same way. And at 11 a.m. I went and got my swab in my nose, and they said probably Tuesday the results will come back, and I will be shocked if it is negative. So for all you people out there, if you've had it, I know what you've experienced now. I basically have what I think is a combination of the cold and the flu. So my nose is all stuffed up. My voice is, I'm coughing. It's kind of deep down here, kind of phlegm. And my body's aching a lot. My legs feel really kind of whatever. And I get a fever that comes and goes here and there. And other than that, like right now particularly, I feel a little bit okay, which is why I'm doing these videos, because I'm like, oh, I gotta get these pay for plays out of here. So without further ado, let's move on. We have the hodgepodge number 3 going on today, and we have several pay for plays that we need to get to. For those of you, I haven't actually received any pay for plays this past week, so maybe people are calming down because the vacation is over. But for those of you who are coming to this channel for the first time, this is how you do a pay for play. Next week, if no one, you know, comes in with any more pay for plays this week, well then hopefully I will be better from this stupid thing and I will be just doing my own if nobody pays for the pay for play. So we are going to start now, and up first is going to be a nice one. Now again, don't cheat. For those of you who, you know, are not good kids when you were waiting for Christmas, this is a hodgepodge. So just wait until it shows up, and we will get to our first song now. First up is Devin Townsend Project, Key. I think it's Key or Kai, Ki, Ko, Ki. I don't know. Oh, is this gonna be ethereal? Ethereal, Devin? Better turn off my phone so it doesn't ring. Videos not very HD. Mm-hmm. It's got like an acoustic effect on it. Oh, there actually is an acoustic guitar. Or mate, no. Man, I love this so much. So good. The night is on. Nice palm muting there.
The night is on.
This seriously could be a song that I go to sleep to. Looks like the bouncers are having problems with somebody up front. This is awesome. This is so heavenly. I'm like, I'm seriously getting tired. Half of it being because I'm sick. The other half because this is just transcendent. Nice. Sounds like you're in space. I like how that background vocals is coming up. Oh, band's there, so now it's gonna break into something. building. Very classically focused. Let me sneeze. I mean, what can you say about that? That is exactly the kind of Devin that I love, absolutely love. And the way that it built up at the end was absolutely gorgeous, just gorgeous. And I mean, the videos wasn't the best as far as like being able to see it, but you didn't really need to see anything in this one. You just had to like let yourself go and listen to it. And it was definitely beautiful. At the beginning, it had that electric guitar, electric and acoustic guitar mix modulation, whatever that pedal is. I call it the electric, or acoustic electric mix. And that pedal, whatever it is, it always reminds me when I hear it, when certain people use it, is one of my favorite. My brother actually bought it for me randomly, I think my senior year of high school, for a birthday or something like that. Maybe it was right going into my senior year. Called Craig Chiquiso. It looks like Craig Chiquiquo, but it's pronunciated Craig Chiquiso. And he's like this Native American kind of electric guitar, very new agey. It was found in the new age section at Borders Books and stuff like that. And I mean, I cannot tell you how many times I've listened to his albums, a lot of them. Acoustic Highway, if you're looking for that, is really just a beautiful, beautiful, well-written album. I think he was the guitarist, if I remember correctly, for Jefferson Starship. And he's awesome. He's a little sloppy sometimes, but the kind of runs that he's doing is really cool, and it's got this kind of sound, and I absolutely love it. So that is two thumbs up for that song. I think I just want to make a compilation of Devin with his ethereal sounding songs like this, because I could just sit here and listen to this for hours and hours and hours. I'm not even joking. Sick or not sick, I could listen to this for hours. So great pick, and you know, I'm looking forward to hearing more of those if you got any more of those. And let's move on to the second one. Sounds like don't forget what you've learned these long Crosby, Stephen Nash. The bridges you burn made the world. Oh, I love his voice. Is it gonna make me cry like the last Arcane one? Those harmonics.
Always will be my little girl.
Love that. Great melody. Very memorable.
We'll have time then. We'll have time then.
And we're just going with the ballad ethereal songs today. Sounds like something. That. The little melody right there. Man, this is definitely ethereal day, which without me having a ton of energy, that kind of putting me to sleep pretty quickly. I love it. I'm seriously like, oh, yeah, that's a great, that's definitely going on my playlist right away. So we've got two for two again today, man. These pay for plays, I can't explain to you how much it's heightened, or maybe it's just, it can't be by chance. It's like most of these songs I like. I think there's only been one or two in the whole pay for play for the last like month that I haven't liked. I mean, this is, these are great suggestions by you guys. And I would say for this song, it's good, but I wouldn't call it great. It's beautiful, definitely going on my playlist, but I wouldn't put it up there with the last song that we heard by them. I can't remember what that song's name was. I gotta look it up. And I would say it's not as good as Resonate. Resonate is still, that's gonna be like the one to beat for me, because that when it comes to their ballady, kind of like slow ethereal stuff like this, Resonate is just something I have to have on repeat because I love it so much. But great job. Another good suggestion. I love it. Absolutely love it. It's going on my playlist. Maybe as I listen to it more and more, it'll become more ingrained in my head to where I can just sing it without having to listen to it. So, all right, let's go to number three, pay for play. Wow. Okay, this is a new band, Mother of Millions. Song name is Silence. It's got a very U2 feel. You did say it was like UK rock. Ooh, I like that dun dun dun. I like this so far. Ooh, good transition there. Good transition. Oh. Why did it switch like that, though? It's like the bass got really quiet and the voice got really loud. No, go back to the way it was sounding before that. Yes, definitely has like a UK U2 drive. That dun, da 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 kind of thing. His voice is fucking awesome. Nice switch there. I love that dun dun dun. This is very different. I like it. The way they're setting up the measures is very different. Yeah, like that. It's like a lot of stuttering, but like not too much to where there isn't like a cohesiveness to it. Ooh. Yes. I know what I've seen. all that bound. Dude, I'm liking this a lot. See, that was good. That wasn't a scream, but it was like a... still got across the same feeling as a scream. This reminds me of a Christian band right here, just this section, called Plank Eye. Does anybody know the band Plank Eye if you're a Christian? Obviously I'm not anymore, but when I was a Christian, I'd listen to that stuff. And this reminds me of Plank Eye. Take the plank out of your own eye before you try to remove the plank from your brother's eye. I like that. Dude, I like this. This is very much like a... I will say this right now, we're halfway through the song. If it doesn't take kind of like a good right turn or left turn and change things up, I think 8 minutes is too long for this. But let's see what happens in the next 4 minutes. Because I feel like it needs to be like, ticka, 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 ticka. I like it though. I like it. Just take a turn. Take a turn. I wanted it to take a turn. Did anybody else feel that, or is that just me? I mean, it's still good. I just think it would have been better with the turn. Ooh, okay. Nice break up there by the drums to make it different and unique. Honestly, I like the idea behind the song, like the feeling of it. It felt weird when I heard that. I thought it was something else behind me. Today we are in ethereal land. Okay, so some really, really strong uniqueness from this band. First time I've ever heard of. You guys ever heard of this band before? This was really, really good. I would say the beginning all the way through until I said there needs to be a change. There wasn't that much of a change, and I don't think that that was wrong. I think it could have been better if there was a good 3 minutes of an explosion and then back to the end, going back to that. That'd be cool, but for 8 minutes of just kind of like it's almost like a Riverside thing where it was like it kind of gets there and then it goes down. It kind of gets there and it goes down. It doesn't like explode and push through the limits. And I just think for me, not this is not for anybody else. For me, I like a song that has those elements where, just like a story, every story, even if it's not a good story, pretty much every story that's ever told has, you know, the whole, like, mountaintop, right? You have, like, rising conflicts, and you have rising of the setting, then you have the rising kind of situations, then you have the climax, then you have falling resolution, and then you have the end. That's a story. That's the way we live our lives, everything. So, like, to me, it's pretty natural that there should be. And there could be, at times, a good dissonance between not everything having to hit a climax and just kind of making you feel like you're going to hit a climax, but not. That's cool. But 8 minutes long of that, you could have do that in 4 or 5 minutes is all I'm saying. Oh, I'm going to sneeze. Oh, maybe not. Okay. So I would say, is this kind of it's still, to me, an ethereal kind of situation, but I definitely think that I love the rhythm of it. It reminded me of like the Harlequin Forest ending kind of rhythm. Like where you have to listen to it a couple of times, and then once you listen to it a couple of times, you can get it and figure out where it's going. So definitely happy to hear this. Have you guys heard this? Write in the comments below if you've listened to this before, this band. Send me more about these guys. It definitely at the beginning had a U2 kind of UK feel, and then it kind of switched and went into like a heavy section that was really good. So definitely impressed with this band, want to hear more of it, just thought it was a little bit too long. Let's move on to the next one. Another Deer Hunter song coming your way, The Most Cursed of Hands, Who Am I? I like that picture, man. Totally reminds me.
Went down to the river.
Love the harmony.
To fall, to lose it all.
I noticed their music, the more I think about it, has like a country feel to it.
He lost his sights, narrowed eyes, tempted by his right desires.
Love that bass sound.
Damned to cross.
Switch.
Faded past.
Man, I really like these guys. They're such a blend of everything.
Come to pass.
Is it getting faster? Yeah, it is. Back to country. Man, these guys really hit a lot of different styles. It's almost got like a gospel feel to it and the singing.
So with cunning class, he offered fast to sow the wager had
feel like watching Wyatt Earp. Wyatt Earp is my friend. Devil smiled, looked in his eyes. Hymns with the Devil in Confessional, Act 5. Makes sense. Sounds hymnish and like that one song, I Went Down to the River, or what is it? Oh, that was sick. Is it Duel with the Devil? That song where he's like the violin. There it is. Beautiful. Great dynamics. Deer Hunter is like moving up the list pretty quickly of like bands that I really, really like. Getting more like color. Nice. Set the devil free. Total change there, total change. Just a gambler. And it makes sense because the story is changing. So normally I would say that didn't fit, but you can tell in the story it's supposed to change. I feel like a cunning devil serpent. It's got that feel to it. I feel like this could come out of like Grease. Like this is a very Grease kind of has this kind of like major switches. As I said, I think this band, it's so funny. I always said one thing that's great about progressive, and of course, in my particular opinion, one of the things I love about Dream Theater is I feel like they can do all styles at any time if they wanted to, and not just like, oh, we kind of know it, but like they can do it and it sounds good. It's well placed, well put together. And I think in general, like progressive is kind of like a melting pot of all different styles into one. along with other elements as well. And I would say more than any other band I've heard before, Deer Hunter kind of goes all over the place in their ability to bring different styles and feelings, even within its own song. But it's not, what's what I'm looking for? It's like, it's not misplaced. It's very fitting what's going on in the song, especially even just by the title. I know exactly what they're talking about in the lyrics, but you can tell it fits and it's well done and purposeful, not just like this random, hey, look, we can play these different styles. We're just going to try to do something to be different and unique. No, it makes sense what's going on. So yeah, Deer Hunter is definitely someone that's moving up the list pretty quickly of bands that I like to hear and look forward to hearing what's going to come fucking next. And the next song could be friggin' opera in the next one. Who knows? So guess we'll find out when somebody else pays for play for that one, or we just get that one going on. So we have one more to go. Let's get to it. One Day Like This. Band, like the song name is Elbow, or the band name's Elbow? I'm thinking it's the song name. Man, we're really on the ballads, kind of, other than the Deer Hunter one. Ethereal, ballady. Drinking in the morning sun. It's very poppy. Blinking in the morning sun. Like it. Shaking off the heavy wall. I have you like a loaded gun. What made me behave that way? Using words I never say. I like the following of the strings with his voice. Good, nice way to go back to the verse. Didn't do it. And only now I see the vibe. Bum 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 bum. Oh, anyway. One Day Like This. Elbow's the band name, sorry. I just realized that. One day like this, one day like. If you think I wink a day. One day like this, one day this. Laugh politely at repeats. It's got a very, my lips are thin. Bum 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 bum. And only now I see the light. Yeah, lying with you half away. Stumbling. That's what it is. What to say, well, anyway. It's looking like a beautiful day. It's got a very Love Actually feel to me, the movie Love Actually. Maybe just this part, I don't know. That old guy who sings, fucking funny. He's hilarious. Taking a piss on himself and becomes famous. I would say at this point, it's getting kind of repetitive. Too repetitive. dum dum. For me, too repetitive for me. Like, I feel like it could fade out right here. There's still fucking two minutes left. Is it just gonna be this for 2 minutes? Maybe because I'm sick, I'm not down for it, but. I feel like I'm at church and they just keep playing the same ending to get people to go to the altar call. It's like, okay, yes, I feel it. I feel it. Just repetition makes me feel it. So now, Jesus, you're my savior. Again? I really feel like this is a worship sort of church song since 3 minutes and 30 seconds. There's the fade out. Okay, so I just realized, I'm not trying to be a dick. I'm just trying to say that, like, I think I've come to the realization that the best way I can put it most simply for my taste, remember, we're talking about my taste. This is my reaction. I don't want you to piss you off, people. These are just my thoughts, my reactions. That's what it is, Captain Morgan's Reaction Channel. I would love to hear your guys' reactions and your differences of opinions on that if you had your own reaction channel, so start one. But that being said, I just realized after this song, what I think the best way to simplistically boil it down to is, I have no, for me and my tastes, I love simplicity. I remember always when I was in high school or whatever, and I started liking Dream Theater and they were my main band and blah, blah, blah. People were like, it doesn't have to be complicated to be good. And I'm like, I know, it doesn't. It doesn't. I still believe that. And I would always get pinned as like, if it's not really difficult and intricate and stuff like that, that I wouldn't like it. No, there's lots. I mean, I'm a child of the 80s. Most of those ballads and stuff that come from the 80s are not really technically difficult, but I love the songs anyway. So it's not about being simplistic or being technical or being, I don't give a shit about any of that. But it's like, if you're gonna be simplistic, that's cool. Then be simplistic. Like, just, you know, don't make it a 10-minute song of simplistic. If you're gonna be intricate, you know what I mean? Like, it's kind of like, it's like shit or get off the pot kind of thing. And that's the way I feel. It's like, if you're gonna like just repeat the same thing over again, I have no problem with repetition in of itself. I just have a problem with repetition when it's like, okay, it's been too long. We're doing this for way too long. So it's setting proper boundaries, I guess is what I'm saying for me. I like when there's proper boundaries. And you don't have to have the boundaries here and there necessarily, but if you're gonna have them and you're gonna, that's what you're going for, then have the boundaries. I don't know if that makes any sense, but this song, I would say it started out good. I liked it, but it definitely could have been 3 or 4 minutes long, and that's it, not 6 minutes and 30 seconds or whatever it was. And just basically from 3 minutes and 30 seconds, which is half the song, it just repeated, which for those of you who have not been to church, this is the quintessential church go-to when it comes to an end of a service altar call grabbing at their hearts kind of thing. They just repeat the same chorus over and over and over and over and over and over. So I think people go into submission because they just want it to end. Not because they actually want to believe in Jesus, but they're just like, I want to get the fuck out of here. So yes, if it takes me like saying, I love you, Jesus, you're coming to my heart, then I will, to get this fucking song to end. This is like the quintessential. So if you haven't been to church, you just heard what church basically does when they kind of end a service. At least the churches that I went to when I was, and they weren't even like gospel churches. They were just regular churches that, yeah, musically, it was very like repetitious and out of control for me. So anyway, I enjoyed this as well. Hodgepodge number 3. As I said before, I would say again, with the exception of the last 3 minutes of this song, every song was good, including this song. Like, I would say this was a good song up until 3 minutes and 33 seconds when I started getting bored. And so I feel like these pay-for-plays are good. And if there's no more pay-for-plays this week for more songs next week, well, then I will just choose a couple to do myself. And there's so many bands that I can choose from now. And, you know, if there are no pay-for-plays, then I'm just going to choose randomly what I feel like listening to. And if there are pay-for-plays, then we'll definitely listen to those. So that's kind of like where we're at in this channel, is for those of you who it's important enough for you to get all of the other suggestions out of the way and put yours at the top, you can do it. But if you don't want to do it, well, then you're just going to have to pray that I happen to pick one that you like. And that's the way it is. So I enjoy it. Either way, for me, I enjoy it. So it's just about whether you enjoy it or not. Hopefully you do. And yeah, that's that. Hopefully next week at this time, I'm pretty much over this, I'm hoping. They always say like, you start to feel better before you get worse again. So maybe next week, Wednesday or Thursday, I might start feeling better. And then maybe next weekend, I'll start feeling worse again. I hope not. Let's hope that I've been taking a lot of vitamin D. So hopefully that's helped in the situation. I've been doing it for the last 3 or 4 months because they have shown clear correlation that vitamin D is actually really helpful when it comes to how sick you get or if you get sick at all. So I obviously got sick. Let's hopefully it hits the second part where I don't get too sick. If I keep just like this for a couple days, I can handle it because it's just like waves of like fever and body aches with cold. But if it gets worse, that's not going to be fun, because I wouldn't say I'm happy right now. I'm just not miserable. So anyway, as always, like and subscribe, and we will see you guys next week. Peace.